Greetings, fellow maker. You've got Bill in the shop today, and I've been playing a ton of Starfield. I'm a bit of a super fan. I've got my collector's edition fancy pants case with the very cool opening and closing mechanism. I've got my collector's edition watch, boop, 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 a genuine smartwatch with a ton of features. And I've been playing just a ton of the game, like 50 hours in, and I'm having a blast. There's something about Bethesda games, like the Fallout games or the Elder Scroll games, that just suck me in. They're worlds I want to live in. I want to exist there. I want to play with all the stuff. Starfield has so much good stuff. There's spaceships, there's space suits, space helmets, and space guns. And I'm going to make one of those space guns. I'm going to make a ton of stuff from the game, I'm sure. But I'm starting with the Rattler from Starfield as my first project because it's the first thing that really spoke to me. There's something about that Western meets sci-fi aesthetic, that space cowboy thing that I'm really into. I'm also a sucker for big chunky revolver looking weapons. So I'm going to be making one of those in a future video, and today I want to collect reference images from the game, and I figured it was a good opportunity to share with you how I both collect reference images from a video game and scale them so that they are appropriately sized. So I'm gonna load up the game, show you how we gather those images, and then we'll jump into some free software. I use Inkscape to show you how to collect all those images and scale them so that we can make them the appropriate size. Now I'm gonna be 3D modeling this one for 3D printing, but this works for foam smithing, for scratch building. It's the first step no matter how you're making a prop, and that is of course getting your reference images. Let's go dive in. I've been playing my game on my PC, and I'm gonna record a video of the screen. So if I hit Windows G, I can hit this record button, and that'll just grab everything going on the screen. If you're playing on a console, I'm sure they have a way to do screen recording. The first thing I wanna do is get some animation reference. So I'll fire it a couple of times, then I'll reload. That way I know where those parts come apart if I want to include those mechanisms in my prop. Let's go to our inventory. Here's my dude here, Doug Thruster, level 37. This is really great. I love that they include the ability to look at stuff like your spacesuit. You can get a full 360-degree rotation of your suit. If you wanted to build this, you could zoom in, get some nice views of that, especially like the helmets. If I go to my helmet here, we can get even closer look at the helmet if we wanted to make this as a wearable costume prop. Let's go to our prop that we want to replicate. I can get a full screen view of it. First, I want to get some nice perspective shots of this. Zoom in on any details like this text right here. I know I want to replicate that text, so we want to get a good shot of that. I want to get like details like the site here, get inside of that, see what that looks like. Go all the way around. And since we're recording video, we can just pull screenshots out later to use for our references. But once I'm satisfied with all that, I want to get as many views of the front and side and top as I can from as straight on as possible. It's not going to be perfect, but if I line it up like that, that looks like a pretty good front shot. We can rotate to the side. That's a good side shot right there. Rotate to the back. Now I do have to zoom a little bit so I don't clip off the bottom. There we go. That's the back right there. And then the other side and the top and the bottom. Now this is not perfectly straight on. It's not orthogonal. It's got some perspective to it. So if I'm looking at the top here, I'm really only going to be able to pull dimensions off this very top surface or scale everything to that. Same thing with like the front and back. Since the back here is closer and it looks bigger, the front is not going to be perfectly lined up. So these front and back views, they're only kind of useful to us. We're going to be getting most of our information from the side view. I can hit Windows G again and stop that recording, and I'll have that footage that I can then sort through on my PC. I've opened up my footage in VLC Media Player, my favorite media player, and I can go through and grab the shots that I need. If I hit E, it'll advance it by one frame so I can see where the slide kicks back on the top of the gun here. And also if we go to the reload, we can go through that and see some of the details of how that mechanism might work. So that's just for reference. I could clip those screenshots if I want to. But the main reason we're here is to go to our close-up views and get some good screenshots. Like I said, we could grab these perspective shots. Now in VLC, you can right-click, go to video and take snapshot, and it'll grab a shot of the whole frame for you, which can be really handy. We can get some of the close-up views that way. Take another snapshot there. But we really want the side, front, top view. That's what we're going to use for making our patterns or 3D model or whatever. So if we go forward, we can find those shots. There we go. And then for this screenshot, I don't want the whole screen. So I'm going to hit the Windows button and look up the snipping tool. And this will let me snip just a little bit of the screen right there. It takes a screenshot for me and I can save that. So I'll save my front view there and then I can go back to my video and go to the side view. Just like that. And again, grab my snipping tool and cut out just what we need right there and save that. And I'll go around and save, I'll save every view of our gun here, front, top, back, the whole nine yards. I've got Inkscape loaded up. It's a free vector drawing program. It's one of my favorite programs to use for this kind of work. I can drag in. We're just gonna start with just the left view of our Rattler here. And I can drag down a ruler so that I can rotate this so that everything is nice and sort of parallel and lined up. And then I want to scale this. The first thing I want to do is make sure it's the right size. So step one is to bring in a scale reference. I've got this image here. I'm also going to drag into Inkscape. That is my hand holding an airsoft gun. And I'm going to set the opacity to 50% so we can see through it. And there's a ruler in this image. I'm going to make sure I hold control while I scale this up. I'll make this look appropriately sized for my hand, and then I can use that ruler to figure out how big it is. So we're going to keep going, line up my hand with the hand or the handle in the reference image there until I think it's about the right size. I think it needs to be a little bigger. There we go. That looks pretty good. I'm pretty happy with that. Now my screenshot from the game and my reference image here are the same size roughly, but they aren't necessarily scaled yet. So I have this ruler here and I can go from, let's say, from 1 to 18, so 17 inches. I'm going to go to File, Document Properties, and I'm going to set the width here 2 inches and 17. And I can use the page, this, which is now 17 inches wide, and I can scale both of these images until that 1 and the 18 are lined up. I can zoom in to make sure everything's pretty close. I'm basically making this image 1-for-1 with reality. There we go. There we go. So now hopefully this image is both sized appropriately for my hand and also scaled 1-for-1. And what I'll do is print this out on my laser printer and hold my hand next to it and see how it looks. So let's do that. Actually, I'm gonna set the opacity to 50% on this so I don't use as much toner. Then we'll print it out. Before I print it out, I almost forgot I need to set my document properties back to letter. There we go. So that it prints on the appropriate size paper. There we go. Now we'll print. Here's the reference all printed out. If I hold my hand up there, it looks pretty close. I can even grab one of my other props and compare it. And I think that this could actually be a little bit bigger. I think I got it close, but I can go back into Inkscape and scale that up just a little bit, maybe like 5 or 10% bigger, but it is really, really close. So I can come here and drag this up a little bit, print out another one, see how it fits, and so on until I get it just right. Now that I've scaled this appropriately, this view, I can bring my other views in and really sort of figure out all of the different perspectives, different views. So if I grab the back, pull that in. Actually, we can make this 100% again. I can use these guys to line these up to like different landmarks. So the top of the site there, I can add another one down to the bottom here and move our image over here. And you can see I definitely have to scale this down a bit to get it to fit. And if I have to fine tune this, I can go grab the percentage up here. I can scale it by percentage. I can link the two. Let's make this like 95%. And I can use the arrow keys to move this. And that's pretty much spot on. So there's our back view. I'll get the bottom. I'll get the rest of them all lined up for you and then we'll reconvene. There we go. That's everything all laid out. There's the other side view, but it's actually mirrored from this one, so I don't think I need to include it. And then this is pretty much most of our thing laid out. And again, the perspective is a little wonky, so it isn't a perfect like orthographic projection. But this gets us to a really great starting point. In fact, we can now draw. This is on a layer. I could lock this layer just like you do in Photoshop. And then I can start drawing a pattern on top of this, breaking apart into layers if I'm going to make this out of foam. Or I could export this whole image to use as a canvas in something like Fusion 360 to start making my 3D model, which is what I'm going to do. And I'll show you how to do that really quickly. First, I want to make my document a little bigger here so I can fit everything inside of it. I can unlock that layer. I can move all of these down into our document. And then I can export this. If I go File, Export PNG Image, and I want to export the entire drawing, or the entire page. I want to export the entire page, and I'll send that to wherever that wants to go. I'll go grab that image, and then we can dump it into Fusion to start doing our 3D modeling. But first, I need to grab a measurement from in here. So I'm going to zoom in. There is a measure tool right down here in Inkscape. And I'm going to grab millimeters, because that's what Fusion uses. And I just need 2 points on this image, 2 known points. So let's go from the middle of this screw here to the middle of this screw over here. And that's 89-ish millimeters. I'll show you why that's relevant in a moment here. Let's load up Fusion 360. All right, in Fusion, you can set a background image, a canvas. If I go to Insert, Canvas, I can grab from my computer and find that image. And it will dump it on one of the planes here. We're gonna pick the, let's say the right plane. And there is our image. And you could scale it up right here, but we don't have to do that. We can hit okay. And then we can go to that canvas that it added, right click on it and go to calibrate. I'll click on the right view. We'll click on those 2 screws from there to there. We type 89 and it rescales the whole thing so that it should be the appropriate size. So now we have an image in Fusion that is the right size so we can start 3D modeling it. And that's really important because you don't want to be rescaling these pieces after you've started making them. We're going to use real screws, real hardware on this, and that's going to be picked ahead of time. So everything needs to fit. I can't just grab the whole thing and bump it down or up by 10% later because it'll goof up all that stuff. So that's it. for my 3D modeling. I'm ready to get started. I can put these views on different planes. If I add that canvas again, I can add the front view, add the top view, whatever I need as it goes. But like I said, the side view gives us most of the information that we need. And I'm ready to get started. That wraps up this video tutorial. I'm really excited to dive into this new project. Like I said, we're gonna have a full build video, including 3D print files so you can print them yourself at home. I've also got some others available over on our website, including my Blade Runner blaster. If you wanna go download this for a fair fee, you can grab the files for this and print it yourself and build your own prop, as well as the Vash the Stampede Revolver, one of my very favorite projects. I love this kind of problem solving. It's got moving parts, very satisfying moving parts. All these things open, these mechanisms all work. I'm really excited to dive into that new one. I hope you're excited to watch along with me. If you found Inkscape to be super useful and you wanna learn more, we have a premium video for sale over on our website that dives into everything I know about the program. It's great for pattern making and prop making, of course. We'll have links to everything else down below if you wanna check those out, including that pistol image I used of my hand with a ruler in it. That's for free, linked down below. Thanks so much for watching, hanging out in the shop. I really appreciate you being here. I especially appreciate the members of our Extra Credit Club. Those are the fine, beautiful human beings who keep us employed. If you wanna join in and get early access to all of our videos, then you can support us over on Patreon or right here via YouTube memberships. Thanks again, happy crafting, and we'll see you in the next build.